I spent a bit of time with the Galaxy S10 as my main device, only switching recently to the Huawei P30 Pro. During that experience with the S10, I grew to like the hole punch aspect of the display. And coming over to the P30 Pro to a more typical notch, albeit a very small one, it was immediately more distracting to me. You start to appreciate the idea of sticking the front-facing camera in the corner of the display of your smartphone as opposed to the center. There's no doubt to me at this point that the top corner hole punch style notch is the least offensive of all the notches. In front of me, I have a device, a more budget version of a hole punch display smartphone. This is the Honor View 20, and it is the other mainstream, I guess, hole punch smartphone. This one in front of me is Phantom Red, 8 gigs of RAM, 256 gigs of storage. So this one comes in at about $650. Okay, that is a cool arrow effect going on. I have never seen anything like that before. They are doing such interesting things with the rear panel on these smartphones these days. Holy. Now the fingerprint scanner is in a more typical location rather than being in the display. I don't actually mind that. It's really fast, snappy, your finger lands there anyway. Keeps a headphone jack at the top of the device. It also looks like it has an IR blaster. This is a thing that I ended up using. I was turning off the TVs in my house with the phone. Type-C connector. Put a little bit of texture on the power switch. Texture is a better indicator, in my opinion, than a visual difference. And this gives you your first glance at the hole punch. You will need to angle the device a little bit to compensate for the fact that it's not dead center. Some people were surprised by that. So you end up with a little bit of an angle on your selfie. I promise you, it's insignificant. A simple case to protect your device. I appreciate that. It's a nice little bonus. A Type-C cable to charge it up. The supercharge power brick from Huawei. Now, before I power up the phone, I do want to show you the other variant that I have here. This is Phantom Blue. Ooh, I'm probably taking the blue one in that situation. Now, don't ask me how they create this effect on the back. It must be some type of sandblasting to create this gradient. All right, so we have the unit booted up now. As you can see, now the default wallpaper is kind of hiding the hole punch a little bit. I mean, this is what's going on with all the manufacturers. You got the stock wallpaper, tries to diminish the significance of the hole punch. The main improvement, whether you have a dark background or a light background, is that it occupies the same space that would typically be used for information anyway. But I'll go ahead and launch into Gallery, for example, so you can get a better idea of how that maps out on a light background. The implementation is almost identical to what Samsung is doing. It's just on the other side of the display. What's the spec on the display, Will? So this is a 6.4 inch display, 2310 by 1080. So of course, a tall display as well. Screen comparison here, the View 20 and the P30 Pro. So this one is IPS LCD. And of course the P30 Pro is OLED. It's a much more expensive device, so you have to take that into consideration. You know, with any LCD, you sort of get this effect of a bit more dullness, especially when you put a little angle on the viewing, and this feeling that the image is buried a little bit below the glass, as opposed to OLED, which just pops right. It feels like it's right on top of the glass. So the chip inside here is a Kirin 980. And the cool thing there is that's the flagship chip that's also in the more expensive P30 Pro. Let's go ahead and load up the camera. I'm a bit curious about this front-facing camera. Beauty level's at zero. I like that. HDR is activated as well. Wow, that is a pretty nice smartphone selfie. The beard hair test, as you would do, you will realize you are dealing with some great detail for a front-facing camera. What's the megapixel count on that? That's a 25 megapixel front-facing camera. That's plenty of pixels. You can still see pores in the skin, which is good. I like that detail. It's a good selfie as far as I'm concerned. Let's go ahead and load up the rear camera. You have a multi-lens setup over here. So you have 1x, the wide angle, and then 2x, of course, 2x the zoom. So the camera layout is really where this device has been trimmed down in comparison to the P30 Pro. You have a different camera layout than what you would get on the P30 Pro. So that's probably the main difference. No ultra wide, less versatility. Okay, so real quick, that's at 1x. And then we'll zoom in, 2x. There's definitely wider cameras out there, and I'm a huge fan of wide angle lenses. So for me, that's one major drawback of this device, is it doesn't have any kind of ultra wide. And then there's the zoom. And if you're wondering about the megapixel count, there's an absolute boatload here. This is one of those 48 megapixel sensors, which is just bananas. So in terms of battery, you're looking at 4,000 milliamp hours. That should be plenty for most people. It's also got supercharged, so you can get up to 55% battery life in 30 minutes, according to Honor. It has night mode as well. We should do a quick demonstration. I'm gonna get this box like this. The camera still sees. These night modes are fantastic. It does take some time. It's insane what they're able to create in pitch black. I was blacked out, and yet we still end up with this image. So that is one of the most compelling reasons to upgrade. So you can see here again how that camera implementation affects certain apps. Dark mode obviously hides it even more. I would typically use this in dark mode. The hole punch in this location is like the least offensive. You could still live the hole punch lifestyle for a bit less in the form of the Honor View 20. All right, let's check out the speaker real quick.
So it will also charge up the watch. That's another thing that AirPower claimed.
You're firing out of a singular mono speaker, which is not the greatest implementation. You'd love to have something firing forward. And that's Clint Eastwood, by the way, for all you youngsters. Haven't lived properly. It's a cool track. It's not a very loud speaker. It's definitely not the best I've tested. It'll get the job done. You're not gonna notice it. I actually like the rear fingerprint scanner. It never misses, ever. Versus the in-displays, pretty much everyone I've ever used at some point misses. You got it in the red, you got it in the blue. Willie Do, what do you say? Look at that.
It's a very unique look.
It's a ukulele. It's a very unique.
It's very flashy.
Yes.
Like you said, it
turns some heads.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what this phone's about. It's a head turner. It's a Tina Turner.
I agree with you on the fingerprint sensor. I think it should be in the back. It's just so much more reliable.
I know, but unfortunately, like, that's becoming extinct.
I know. Yeah.
I feel like we're not going to see that a lot in the rest of 2019, 2020.
I think in-display is the future, but yeah. Not like a zone where it's just like you have to tap a specific spot.
If it's the whole screen.
The whole screen, yeah. Like the Vivo Apex concept, that would work really well.
That's a good call. If you've never used one of these, it's surprisingly natural to have the scanner in that
location. Yeah. I think when it comes to in-screen fingerprint, just have it full screen. That would be the most ideal.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Hopefully in 2019.
You don't have to think, you just touch. Mm-hmm. That's what you do most of the time.
All the time.